Hello everyone, welcome to another week in our garden. We're out in the sunshine at the moment. It's turned into a lovely day, but this morning it was at least minus two and everything was frosted up. Still a bit cautious yet with the weather. Now, I've been down the bottom and lifted some leeks just before the frost came out the ground, so I didn't make too much mess. And I'm going to dress them now, ready for going up to the house. I did pull some carrots yesterday, so they can be used as well, and there's still plenty of vegetables in the freezer from previous crops. So let's have a look at the leek. Right, that's how they come out of the ground. It's a bit of a mess. Let's see what we can do. We'll use the garden knife for them. Not, we just take the thick off straight into the compost. Okay. Just take that thick off for now, and then we strip the leaves back up. It looks better as you go in. So it's nice and clean, got a nice long shank on it, that's fine. Then, good sharp knife, and then just clean those off. There you are. And snip. Then the top, some people cut them off at an angle to keep them fancy, but because they're going straight in the kitchen, I just take mine off. Okay. If I leave too much on the top, when Diane cuts the top for preparing, I'll only have to bring it back down and put it back in. So I'll finish these and then I'll show them finished. There's four nice leeks ready to go up the house now. Now I'm hoping that we get a leek and potato soup with these, because that's my absolute favourite. If anybody hasn't made leek and potato soup, you've missed it now. Right, we'll take these in the shed. I'll get these gloves off and then we'll set some onion seed, because it's time we add them in, okay? Right, here we are in the shed now. Now we're going to put the onions in that we're going to grow from seed. Now you have to forgive me a little bit. I'm absolutely full of cold. I just hope it doesn't turn into man flu. I should be in trouble. So I'm going to put the onion seed in. And now the thing about the onions is we start as early as we can, or should I say as early as we dare, because as the onion grows, it grows leaves until the daylight hours get to about 16 hours, and then it stops producing leaves and produces the bulb. Now every leaf you have is a layer around the bulb, so the more leaves you can get growing on them, the bigger the bulb you'll get at the bottom. And as soon as it gets to 16 hours and hopefully the sunshine on it, that's when they'll mature and they'll store better then. So let's get them in. I'm doing this is a globe onion Santerio. It's a hybrid. I got it from Brown's. I'm not going to put lots and lots in each tray, just a few, because we've got the overwintered Japanese ones down there, but I still like to grow a few from seed. Now, onions we put half inch deep, so it might look a bit full when we're done, but they do need to be half an inch deep. I will take them up to the house just to give them a bit of warmth to get them off, and once they're away they can go, slightly harden them off a little bit, and then they can go into the cold greenhouse. They'll be fine. I should cover them at night with some fleece, so they'll be fine. But so I'm not putting a lot in. I hope I don't sneeze while I'm doing this. I don't know if you can see them because they're blank, but I'm putting very, very few in. That's not even half the packet. I'm going to really seal the packet up, take the air out and seal that up. It might just save till next year. I'll get the label ready as well. And there's the label that we'll be using. Little sieves, compost sieve, just to, so it doesn't have too much of thick compost lumps, if you like, on top. So just keeps it light. Some people put different composts. I always use seed sowing compost. I'm not leaving nothing for chance. It's got everything they need and enough feed in there for the first 3 weeks. So we'll just top this up. We'll just do the one and then I'll show you all three things. Okay. The lumps, I'll, when I put back in there, I'll crush them up again, but it just makes it easier. And then I'll just have a bit of spare wood just to level them off to make it look tidy. Remember, 1/2 inch is fine. That's 1/2 inch or 1.5 centimetres. Most important, the label with the date on. And that's that ready. I'll take it up to house. I shall give it a light spraying of water. The compost is quite moist on its own, but it will need a bit of water on it just to start those seeds off. And they'll be ready, hopefully, as the land warms up and we'll be able to get them straight out. But even if they're not, because I need them growing pretty fast, even if I have to pop them and then put them out, that would be fine. So we'll just finish these three off and then we'll show you them done. Tidying up. That's the first set of onion seed set. I shall spray them with some nice tepid water and just keep the water bottle with them so that it gets the same temperature as the compost does. Now next week I shall probably be setting the broad beans because they need to be in. Some people actually put them in the autumn, but if we did, the squirrels, the pigeons, everything, and have a field day on them. So we'll put them in modules. We'll put the broad beans in these root trainers. We'll do that next week. So that's another job to do. I'll get that organised. Now the other thing this week, the potatoes have arrived today. So we'll unpack them and have a look, see what we got. Now they came from, I bought them from my seed merchant, which is DT Brown, but you can get your seed taters anywhere you like. I'll show you just what to look out for when you get them. So I've taken the packing away. There we go. That's the Ziri, which we've got up foremost. And that's the one we'll be looking at today. We'll be sprouting those up. Right, so that's the potato crop arrived. The seed potatoes have arrived. Now, looking at them, I'm very pleased. There's no spruits. There's a little bit of swelling on the spruits, but there's no real spruits on them, so I'm happy with that. That's the blight-resistant one that we're trying this year, Sarpo Mira. So we'll try that, we'll see how we get on with it. So I've got my Desiri, which is always a good one that Diane likes. You've got your foremost, which that's the one we're going to put in first, so we'll have those in there for sprouting. International Kidney, which is the same name as your Jersey Royal, so that'll be a second early. King Edward and King Edward, they'll go with those. So that's the late crop. First early, second earlies. Because I want these in about 6 or 7 weeks, or when it's easy to do, if the ground temperature gets to 6 or 7 degrees, it's time to get your early potatoes in. That's the easiest way to look at it. So I'm going to put those for sprouting, but these, I don't want these sprouting yet. So I'm going to put them over here with some others that we'd already got. I actually bought these from Homebase, and I bought them because the King Edwards, and there was no spruits on them. Some of them that we saw in the shop had spruits coming out of them already, and you wouldn't want these for another 8 weeks. So we'll have those put there. We don't want these yet. It's no good if they get warm. If we get them warm, they'll start sprouting and we're not ready yet. So these will be all put over there out of the way. And what I shall do then, I shall cover them with my sack. Tuck them in. So actually that is now keeping those nice and cool. I might even put one or two more sacks on top as well. They're cold now, so I don't want them to warm up, so we'll keep them there. Right, the foremost, put it. Yes, it's cut in. Now we're going to put these to sprout. Now in the ideal world that we're not, I would call those seed potatoes. I would call those, they're too big, and some of these, what I would call, too small. So as you can see, the if we grade them, that's about the minimum size I would want a seed potato. These are a very small nut. So if you're buying them from somewhere where you can buy them loose, try and get that sort of size there. That would be ideal. Like a medium-sized duck egg, that is. That would be nice. These, I find they're too big. And these, they're very small. The best thing to do, though, is drop them in twos when we come to plant them. You could say that, I know the farmer wants to get rid of these little ones, so they just get them mixed in. There's nothing you can do about it. Right, so I'm going to put them to sprout. I should put them in my grays now. You've got, which is the best way to show you? There, look, you see? That end, you've only got one, maybe three sprouts in there, but look at them all over this end. So this is what we call the rose end of the potato. So we put that facing upwards, you see? Again, not so many there, loads there, so we put that facing upwards. It's one good use for the, see, just the one, and then that's got several, so we use that. And say it'd be a good 6 weeks before these go in, or unless the temperature changes. We don't, there's no rush for them. I'm just going to keep them in the light and just keep them a little warm. And then when I put them in, I shall probably take some of the sprouts off, so we'll deal with that later. Now the difference between your earlies, your second earlies and your lates, the thing is your first earlies are the faster growing type of potato, so that's why we call them first earlies, because they grow quicker. So let's have these. There are not. That's obviously the rose end. And there, look, and see this, that's a mess anyway, don't have that. If you do get a mess like that at planting, we'll just cut that off. Again, there's one, or there's four or five on that one, put that one. Don't get them too warm yet, there's plenty of time. There you are, look. There's a mess on that one, we'll cut that off later. We'll put the bigger ones in first, and then we'll fill up with the small one. That's obviously the rose end. That's only got one. And put these at the back. Now, if you do get a lot of big ones and you do get spruits coming at both ends, you can always cut them in half when you plant them, but I would sooner plant the right size potato. Look, far too big. There you go, look, rose end. It will fit in that one. Again, they're not too bad really. Little bit disappointed with some of the smaller ones, but we'll do them anyway. Four more. That's it. We'll put the label with them. And we also put our label that we've created with them as well. I'll pop that back there. Now we need somewhere nice and warm and sunny for these, but not immediately. It could be 6-7 weeks away before the weather changes to put them in. So I'm going to keep them in this shed over that side in the sun. So and it's warm in here anyway, but not too warm. Right, I'll just pop these here for now, and the little bit of sun coming through the windows will bring them on. That's an old dahlia tuber I had. I've just put that there to set. We'll have a look at that later when it starts sprouting a bit. But that's the first early step. Right, so we'll go up to the house now. As I say, I'm not very well. So we'll go up to the house and we'll look at the crop rotation. So let's pack up and go up there where it's a bit warmer, okay? So there, we've now come up to the cottage and we're in the little dining room. So we'll talk about the 3-year crop rotation that I use here. But a 3-year rotation is good, 4-year be better, 5-year be better. So you know what I mean, the longer the gap between the crops, the 3 lots of crop we use, the better. As things are, we work a 3-year rotation. So it's simple to me, but it's difficult to explain. So bear with me while we go through it. So let's say this is year 1. Now we split the whole garden into 3, bed A, bed B and bed C. In bed A this year, I'm going to double dig. I'm going to put in as much manure or compost as I can spare, and this will be for the legumes and the alum crops. That's your beans, your peas, your onion, your garlic, your spring onions. And I'm also going to put in the kohlrabi. I've just got enough room to squeeze all those in. I might, at the end of this bed, I might just be able to squeeze the broad beans in as well, okay? So, bed B. Now this, I will dig deep. That means I trench it, and I just turn the bottom with the fork to loosen the pan at the bottom so the potatoes, etc., can get the roots down. If I've got any compost or manure left, I put them in where I'm going to put the potatoes. Now the tomatoes and the peppers, they will also need some deep digging. Now then you've got carrots and parsnips usually go in there as well. Obviously you don't manure where you're going to put your carrots and parsnips, or they'll be splitting and all over the place. Now I'm also going to put in there, between the potato rows, I'm going to put some lettuce and radish. While the potatoes are growing up, that's what you call a catch crop, so I'll do that as they grow. Okay, so let's go to bed C. Now bed C, preparation will be, I should just single dig it, but I shall lime it well. And then with a single dig, I'll keep the ground firm, because this will be for the brassica crops. Now this will be all your cabbage, your cauliflower, your Brussels, your kale, your broccoli. Anything to do with the brassica family will go into that bed. So plenty of lime and keep it firm. You'll have no problems then. Now for year two, remove the crops. So we take the brassicas, will now move to bed A. The potatoes will follow the brassicas into bed C, and then your legumes and alliums will go into there. So everyone's jumped down one bed. So where last year we limed that one, this year we'll be liming this one. We'll be liming bed A. Whereas we deep dug bed A last year for the legumes, now we'll deep dig and fertilise, double dig bed B. And then the potatoes with a light dressing will go into bed C. Year three, we do the same again. The crops move through the beds. So we're back to there again. So, beg my pardon, I'm terribly cold. The beds are now moved along once more, where we limed this one last year, now we're liming this one. Hence we deep dug, double dig that one this year, where we double. So you can see now that we've rotated the crops over the 3 years. If we go back to the fourth year, now you'll find that in the fourth year, we just turn that over. In the fourth year, we've come a full rotation, so we know that within the 3 year rotation, every bed has been limed, every bed has been double dug, and every bed has been manured ready for the next crop. So that way everything's properly organized. But what I do, where if we just take bed C, which is the cabbage and brassicas bed, I have another sheet that I keep down in the shed, and when I get the seed ordered and it arrives, I break the seed down. So I write the seed down so I know where that seed's going to be when it's germinated, where it's going to finish up on the bed. So it makes, like, so you haven't planting things and saying, where am I going to do this? Even the potatoes for the main crop, what sort of lettuce they are, I've got the seed, so then I know. So every bed has its own little sheet. It's getting more organised, so I've ordered the seed and I know exactly where to put them on the bed. It makes sense when it works, because you think, oh, where am I going to plant this? Oh, we're going to plant it there. And it, if something needs to be dug over quickly for that particular crop, or a bit deeper, or needs a bit more fertiliser, you can do each individual crop. I do the whole bed, even the fruit cage has its own sheet where I need to fertilise, etc. It looks a lot of work to do the rotation and getting all these beds sorted, but in the long run it works out quite easily. When you've done it a few times, you can just go through it. But I do like to have everything wrote down. I'm coughing now. Right, so that would be about it as regards the crop rotation. I hope I haven't made it too complicated for you, the rotation, but you have to try it, and once you've done it, you'll soon be into it then. If we do have any problems, we can always show it again and do it. Now we've come up into the dining room. It's getting quite cold outside now. I've brought the seeds in up from the shed, and we'll just pop them in. It'll only take a few days to germinate, and then we'll harden them a little bit and get them out. That'll be about it for this week. I hope you've learnt something. I hope that rotation wasn't too complicated, but it will work. So thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing, and hopefully we'll see you next week. All right, and bye now.